The 1937 501 jean. The fit is very similar to the 1933, the only difference being a little less room in the seat area. The cinch and belt loops are still present. The rivets on the back pockets are now concealed. There's a single needle stitched arcuate again. A single sided Big E red tab, which was first introduced in 1936. The selvedge is present on the watch pocket. These have the Coney Mills red selvedge denim. There's a crotch rivet, and they have a sink button fly. The 1947 501 jean. This was hailed as the definitive five-pocket jean with a neat straight leg fit. The cinch has gone for good now, with the belt loops now being the only method of waist adjustment. These have a double needle stitched arcuate. This is identifiable by the diamond at the centre of the arcuate stitching. The one-sided red tab. You have two different coloured thread used on the pockets. A leather patch. Coney Mills red selvedge. Selvedge is still present on the watch pocket. And I have a zinc button fly. You can also see the concealed rivets from the front view. The 1955 501 jean. They have a fuller leg shape and an overall more boxier silhouette. There's two different colour threads used on the pockets, a double needle stitched arcuate. The concealed rivets are still there. And this is the first time a double-sided red tab was used. In 1955, a leather-like card patch was introduced. Coney Mills red selvedge, selvedge on the watch pocket. The 1966 501 jean. You have slightly more room in the seat than the 1947, but not as much room as the 55. They have a card patch, double-sided red tab, a squarer pocket than the 1955, with a much shallower arcuate. As the bar tacks are used on the pockets, and the rivets are now gone altogether. Coney Mills red selvedge denim. The 1967 505 jean. This is a much slimmer shape than the 501 jeans. These have a leather-like card patch. The 505 being the lot number denoting the jean's shape. And the 0217 indicating that the denim fabric was santharized or pre-shrunk. These have a very deep yoke and a curved waistband, a double-sided red tab, a narrow pocket and a more curved arcuate than the 1966. There's only one colour thread used throughout this jean. These have a copper waist button, not zinc like previous 501s. And these were the first Levi jean to have a zip fly.